So today, in this episode of Pokémath, we'll be talking about Pinsir. Hello and welcome to another episode of Pokémath. My name is Stefan Eriksson and today we're going to be looking at Pinsir. As you can see here next to me, I have a nice copy of Pinsir on my screen. And what does it do, you may ask? Well, for two colors, it does 30 damage and the defending Pokemon cannot retreat during your opponent's next turn. Yeah, that's not why we're having this video, right? No, we're talking about Guillotine Hook, the second attack, which for one grass and two colors lets you flip two coins. And if both of them are hits, it's an instant knockout. Well, that's really interesting because flipping coins, math, ooh, that's what we like to do here. So let's take a look at this so-called benchmark we're going to set. So as you will see very soon, we will pair Pinsir with Cherim. This is what makes this deck really viable. I'm saying viable, but let's just check about that when we get to it a little later, shall we? But for the benchmark here, you are flipping two coins, each of which has 50% chance of getting a heads. Well, since there's two flips, you have to get both them heads. You have a 25% chance of succeeding. That alone is not very impressive. The thing that makes this deck sort of viable and sort of useful is the combination of Glimbo Tangle, which makes you able to reflip if you like, and Will, which can, for the next coin flip you make, say on an attack, make it come out as a heads. And that is the interesting part, because combining those two cards here with Pinsir makes the probability increase significantly. Not just 25% anymore, as but if we're going to see a little later here, a whole lot more. But before we get there, I think there's something we're missing. Oh yeah, maybe it is time for a list. So let's go over and take a look at the list here, shall we? And here is the list we'll be using today. Big shout out to Disableyes, because this is where I got the list. So go check out his video on this. It's quite entertaining, I must say. But to go over the list in brief, well, what makes Pinsir viable is the addition of Cherim, which lets you attach an extra grass energy, or actually as many as you like, to one of your Pokemon that doesn't have a rule box. Which means no Vs, no GXs, but fortunately for us, Pinsir is none of those. Well, what is interesting in this list here is how Glimwood and Will would increase our base damage odds. But before we go into the calculation of that, let's take a look at a few of the cards in this deck. We need to play Mew because of the bench barrier, otherwise we will end up losing very quickly to, say, Urshifu or any other bench sniping decks. We need to be able to remove any opposing chaotic swells. We need to play, in this case, an ordinary rod so we can produce more Pinsirs. We would like to be able to produce at least six. And, of course, we need to draw cards as fast as we can to get the combo running, hence we use the amazing rare Jirachi, we use the Denes, we use a nice setup of four research, three Marnies, just to plow through our deck as fast as we possibly can in order to hit all the pieces that we need in order to pull off this super awesome attack. So, now the question then becomes, what does Glimwood and or Will do for our base damage odds? Let's take a look at that. Now after this list here, we are seeing now, hey, this is some interesting things, but what are the numbers actually behind these coin flips that you see in the list? So I have two Pinsirs with me here. Now first we're going to pair Pinsir with a Glimmer Tangle. Then we're going to pair it with Will. And then we're going to see how the effect is for both of them. So if I just add in Glimmer Tangle, we have looked at this in a different video, actually two different videos, because I like Glimmer Tangle so much. So go take a look. What you have is that you have the probability of succeeding in your first try, plus the probability if you fail, because then you go to the second try, right? So you multiply that with a second success. If you put the numbers in, you get 25% plus 75% multiplied by 25%. Cutting all the numbers here and crunching those, well, we get 43.75% chance of success. That's already a little bit better. But is it better than Will? Because the whole point of adding Will is, well, we reduce essentially to just one coin flip, because the first one will be a heads, because that's what Will would decide. We're barring from any super big misplays here, we're going to say tails, but we are saying it's going to be just a heads, right? So that reduced the attack to flip one coin if heads your opponent Pokemon is knocked out. Now, that's interesting, but what if we combine the two now? What happens here? What we do get with this combination here is, of course, you have the success in the first try, which is then the one coin flip, right? 50%. Plus, if you fail the first one and try it again, then again is another 50%. This is where it's really, really interesting, everybody. So you would think, hey, but will wouldn't work if you would use it again, would it? Now, it actually turns out that it does. So if you decide to reflip your coins with Glimwood Tangle, suppose you got a tails on that one flip you need, well, will would still work. So yes, the first flip in your second attempt will still be a heads. Therefore, you have 2 times 50% chance of hitting. Putting that together, well, that gives a nice 75%. But let's try to look at this. Let's get a good overview of this here. So the benchmark is 25% if you have no help, right? If we add Glimmer Tangle, this increases by 18.75%. Already pretty nice. If we do the will, however, then we get another 25% increase. That's even better. But what if we add both around? Now, then we get up to 75%, so a flat 50% increase. And yeah, Slowpoke, you are right, because we talked about all this if you have to just pull it off once to win, but truth be told, unless your opponent only has one Pokemon play, you would have to pull this off multiple times. So the question really becomes, what does it take to win? And actually, this is where it becomes even more interesting. I like to say the word interesting, as you see here, but what is the unfortunate part here is that we actually need to succeed more than once. Normally in a gameplay, you would have to succeed between 2 and 6 times. Why 2 and 6? Well, 2 if you knock out 2 VMAX Pokemon or tag teams, so 3 prize Pokemon. 6 times, that's the other end of the spectrum, if you knock out 6 single prize attackers. Say, other Pinsirs, for instance, or something that is not worth more than one prize in general, right? So between 2 and 6 times. And that is where we can make a super nice overview, and here, oversimplification alert, everybody, because there's going to be made some assumptions here, so deal with it. So I have taken the liberty to make some nice tables here for you. So first, what we see up here is a nice benchmark table. How do we read such a table? Well, you see for the columns, let's actually start with the rows. That's a lot easier. A rows, that's the number of times you need to succeed in order to win, right? So suppose that you have the first row, there's a nice, nice one in here. Then you see, okay, one row, the first row, that's a one. And if you combine that with the columns, which represents how many turns do you have to win? Because you have to assume your opponent's doing something, right? So for simplicity, I'm assuming you have to win within 10 turns. I could have extended this table, of course, but now for simplicity, we keep it at 10. If you guys are interested in seeing any more, let me know in the comment section below. Then we can extend these tables if you like. But suppose now you want to succeed twice in a game. That means you go to the second row on this table here. And suppose now you want to only have to do this in 2 turns. Well, that's not realistic. Let's do this in 4 turns, because you will have 4 turns to pull it off. And this, of course, under the big assumption that if your opponent takes a knockout, you will have something new to promote. So why do I start with 4 turns? What can win in 4 turns against this deck? Alter creation, attack, 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 game over, right? So that's 4 turns. This is barring, of course, from you running out of bench Pokemon, of course. So one of the big assumptions here. But if that will be the case, then you see here you go to row 2, column 4, and you see that is 0.26. That means you have, 26% chance of actually pulling this off. This, again, another assumption, everybody, that you are able to attack on your, well, in this case, second turn. See, is this even realistic? No. A lot of things actually messes up right now, because if you go first, you can't attack. But if your opponent goes second, he can use Alter Creation, say if it's an AP scenario. Then in your second turn, you can then attack if you attach to me first, right? So, okay, that's something, right? So that means, okay, you can attack then, and then you have 4 turns, right? Because that would be your second turn, your third turn, and your fourth turn. That's it. But sure, normally we have more turns, and you can see as we get more turns, if you only have to pull this attack off successfully twice, because that's the most interesting, that's where Pinsir really shines. Suppose you have the full 10 turns to do it, that means you are able to actually attack, say, 9 times. You would then here see, hey, this is a 76% chance of winning. Not bad, but this, of course, is the benchmark. This will serve as a lower bound because you have no help. If I now add in Glimwood Tangle to the mix, you can then see an overall increase in this matrix. You can just start comparing cell by cell to say, okay, what is the situation with if you're in cell 2-2? So that would be that you have to take 2 KOs in 2 turns. Not realistic, say 2 KOs in 3 turns. Without anything, it's 16%, but if I add Glim with it, it increases to 39%. Interesting. What if I add Will instead? Similar point here. You can always just pause the video and study the matrix a little bit here. But what you do see is there's an overall increase here. For example, earlier it was 39% with Glimwood, but it increases to actual 50% with Will. Pretty good. But now comes the upper bound, right? We had the lower bound, that's the benchmark, because that is the lowest scenario you're in. You're able to attack, but you have no help. Here, you would have both Glimwood and Will. Therefore, you would have an upper bound. That is, if you're able to pull these supporters off every time you need. So, say you're in row 2, column 3 again, you go up to an 84% chance of actually succeeding this. Now, I'll leave it up to you whether you think this is good enough or not. Enough. But while you think about it, let's take a few games. And let's see how we can do with this deck, right? So, well, besides losing a coin flip, which is always fantastic, let's see how our start is going to be in this matchup. See if we're fortunate enough to pull off some Guillotine hooks. That's what we want to do, right? So let's start with a nice little Cherim here because, well, we don't have much other choice, do we now? What are we up against? Oh, ADP. Fun. That means, well, we don't have a lot of turns to pull this off, do we now? Because ADP gets to draw a lot of prizes very, very quick. So let's see what we got. Let's see what we get here. Should hopefully get a Pinsir, that would be nice. Oh, I said that, and we got one. Fantastic. And we even got a double energy here. Let's hope there's no hammers coming our way, and let's try to see if we get something nice from Dreamy Revelation. We got an air balloon. Which means we get to do this again. This is not a terrible turn one. This is not a terrible turn one. Let's see what he's going to do. Well, besides, Alter Creation seems like something that may happen. I don't mind a Marnie. I definitely don't mind a Marnie. Now, just need a Grass Energy. Oh, wait, I said that too early. Ah, Viridian Forest. Now we just need something to retreat with, which means yet another Grass Energy, but we do have Energy Retreat here with, so we are able to do this. Now, big turn ahead, boys and girls. Let's see what we can do. Well, first, we're going to evolve. And if we discard that one, play Will, get that in. Oh, we can actually get everything. Let's use Dreamy Revelation, see what we get here. I actually just need a card to discard. Whoop. This is gonna be big. This is gonna be big. This is unbelievable. Let's do this. Are you ready? Flip 2 coins. Choose a result on this coin flip. Well, I want a heads, please. Nope. You may ignore. Do you want to flip again? Yeah, because we didn't do it. And we want heads because this is where the trick comes in. And there we go. Fantastic. It is gone. Guillotine hooks, everybody. Guillotine hooks. There we go. There we go. Let's see. He did pull off an altered creation, so that is not good. He can take 2 price at a time on our single prices, so whew, that's going to be scary. We do have, for our next Pinsir in play, we do have the Jirachi option, so, well, of course, best is if he doesn't even knock us out, right? Then we get to flip more coins. In this case here, we lost Glimwood. We have no Will on hand, so we are down at our 25% chance of pulling it off. That is not great, no. Let's see. In this game, we need to do it 2 or 3 times. Well, he's not going to help us with another attack team, so we need to pull it off 2 more times. There comes the turbo patch, or metal saucer. It's always surprising how many cards they can actually draw in a turn. It's quite amazing. What did they play? Scary, scary stuff. And a switch, and there's a knockout. Yeah. Oh. From this summer center. They're all golden. It's not to see which one is what. So, whoosh. No. Two prices. That is very scary. Very scary. Now, let's see what we can do. Let's start by shuffling in some stuff first. No, we don't need that. Let's spring bloom this one. So we can make it better by getting a Glimwood, because we can play Will, right? So that those are our options. We can of course improve our odds quite a bit. So how many Glimwoods do we have left? We got one. Is this even worth going for? Of course it's worth going for, because this is fun. Did we get it? Nope. That doesn't mean everything is lost, because we could still just hit it. Let's get that one in. It is going to be a lot of fun. Let's guillotine hug this. No. Ah, that would have been so big. That would have been so big. Now, we're just going to get assault tackled for days, and well... That is so stupid how this is, but hey, we're the one playing the quote-unquote stupid deck, I guess. I can't complain about this stamp, to be honest. So, he's gonna attach there. Let's just see if we can pull off one more. We just want to be able to pull off one more. Was unfortunate we didn't get our Glimwood. It was unfortunate we couldn't play Will, because, well, we need to play something else. This looks pretty safe for them, right? Pretty safe for them, right? But you know what? We're just going to play it out, because I want to see if we can guillotine hug one more time. How we love ADP. Now, we can actually do it one more time. Let's see what we get here. Another Marnie. Let's get the energy out. We want to see if we can get our Glimwood. That's kind of what we want to do right now. Let's just attach to itself. That doesn't matter, because we can already attack. So let's see what we get. I want the Glimwood, because I want to be able to pull this off again. No. Deck didn't want us to. And nope, that was it, ladies and gentlemen, that was it. Then it's all about a retreat and a KO from there. Well, not even a retreat, sorry, because I keep forgetting that is not a Sashin, it is a Samacenta. Game over! Great deck! And now after these games here, what do we actually think about this here? What do we actually learn? Well, we learned about the probability of succeeding on Pinsir's attack, if you just look at attack by attack. And then, of course, we oversimplified a little here. Yes, oversimplification. But just to give you an idea of what it actually takes to win with this deck. Well, this was another episode of Pokémath. I hope you enjoyed it, and until next time. Hey guys, thanks for watching today's video. I hope you enjoyed it, and well, we learned a few things about Pinsir. Well, maybe don't take it to an event. That's kind of what we learned, maybe. I'll leave that to you guys. And please don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you want information about new videos coming out, and I will appreciate it immensely. With that said, thank you very much again, and until next time.